thank you for your service. The film is based on a book of the same name. I read the book when it was out as a galley, and it's one of a handful of books that changed me. It cracked my heart open and made me aware of the seismic struggle so many of our brave soldiers face when they return from tours. Circles that are often more difficult on their families than the deployments themselves, and wounds that are sometimes more difficult to deal with when they can't be seen. Joining me now is the film's writer and director, Jason Hall, and David Finkel, author of that book I read. Thank you for your service that inspired the movie. Let me ask you first, Jason. These aren't characters in a movie. These are the real lives of real Americans. And I wonder, you also wrote and directed American Sniper, which brought the reality of war to so many people that sort of live lives separate from the lives of our military families. Can you talk about sort of what drives you to bring us together?
I think it's, we just forget about these guys. You know, I've seen it happen. I saw it happen with Chris. And he came home to book deals and acclaim, and these are blue-collar soldiers. So it's a tragedy that we forget about them, and it's been something that I've set my eyes on and felt like I could do something about it.
And I guess where American Sniper, you know, brought us into the battlefield, this brings us into the battle they face at home. So many of them come back with PTSD or TBI, and it's not like, it's hard enough to get those diagnoses and to get on the right sort of regimen to deal with them, but it's difficult to actually access the services. Can you talk about that?
Yeah, a lot of these guys, it's hard for them to get to the point where they feel like they're ready to go seek help, and then they get to the VA and they find that help is very, very elusive. And David covered that well in his book, but I don't think a large population of civilians have any idea what these guys go through and how tough it is to get services.
David, I read the book. I got one of the early copies. I gave it to everyone that I know. And I wonder if you can just talk about some of the people that have stayed with you and what it feels like to see them played out by actors on the big screen.
Well, they've all stayed with me. It was that kind of reporting. I'm glad you liked the book. I hope, if you haven't seen the movie, I hope you get a chance to see it. Authors, I guess, aren't supposed to like the movies, right? But I love this movie because I think Jason found the heart of what I was trying to do through my reporting in my book and brought it forward in a way that's very moving and very searing, I think.
Can you talk about what the sort of pride factor is for these men? They've stood up to unthinkable challenges on the battlefield. They have seen things that most people can't even process if they even want to. And then they come home and they have a hard time talking about what they've seen. They have a hard time reconnecting with their nuclear families and their communities. Can you just talk a little bit more about that struggle for people who don't know?
Sure. Yeah. You know, and it's not just the people who have been soldiers who have been in combat and they're now home. It's also their families. What unifies all the people that I wrote about in my book is no matter how well they behaved, and many of these people have just behaved during combat and in the recovery process in ways that I wish I could summon in my own life. Just great, great people, but inside of them, for whatever reason, is some small corner of shame in many cases that they're dealing with. There's a guy, both in the movie and in my book, I mean, imagine this. He was blown up in a Humvee. His leg was broken. He got out of the Humvee and realized there were still people inside. And I mean, this happened. I was there, so I'm telling you the truth. Made his way back to the Humvee and pulled two guys out. And then he realized there was somebody else in the Humvee that nobody could get to who burned up and who died in the Humvee, which caused this man who had behaved so perfectly in that moment, I think, to my thinking, to begin having a dream. And the dream, again and again, was the guy he didn't save. And in the dream, he was on fire saying, why didn't he save me? So this is what this guy, who behaved so well, gets to contend with. And it just filters out from soldiers through families through all the recovery processes going on right now in communities across the country as these wars continue and the after effects of the wars continue.
Jason, let me ask you quickly, you're going to continue to make movies about, I think, to people who aren't in the military, these are movies about heroes, but these are also the movie, the better